great catch.
Oh, there it is. We'll have to go get it.
It's no big deal. I'll buy another frisbee.
You know I have to work for an hour to earn $5.
You don't have a job.
If I had a job, I'd have to work for an hour. But then I don't have an old man picking up the tab every time I turn around.
So, get a job.
Oh, it's pointless. I don't work for wages. You end up with nothing, like Gramps.
There's the Persephone. Who's the boat with her?
A beauty little boat.
She's unusual. Never seen her before.
Wonder who she belongs to.
How was she?
Oh, she's cream.
Nice sign.
Yeah, Sarah did it.
Alan spent 7 years restoring it. Too bad he gets seasick.
Yeah, some guys are like that. He gave it a good try. 6 months is a long time.
Hey, guys.
Hey.
Who owns the boat?
Alan Crispin.
Oh, are you guys buying?
Oh, I wish we could afford to. She's a honey.
Well, who do I have to talk to?
About what?
About the Alibi Wahoo. I may be interested in buying her. I'm not kidding.
You better talk to Nick. He's handling the sale.
How much?
I admire your taste, Pat. She's strong, pretty, and very expensive.
How much?
$56,000.
Well, I'd have to look her over and take her out for a run, of course.
Pat, she's $56,000.
Well, but that's not firm yet.
Well, you better get yourself a job first.
I could make money with this boat, grab the executive market.
What's that?
You know, scouting for movie locations, commercials, charters, maybe even tow a log or two. I want this boat.
Yeah. I felt the same way about Ginger Broxted. Didn't do me any good. Everybody wants what they can't have. It's human nature.
If you can dream it, you can do it.
Maybe. But not with Ginger Broxted.
After Alan and his wife split up, he went to Australia. Now he wants to sell his boat so he can start up a flower farm.
It'd be nuts to trade that boat for a patch of posies.
Hi, fellas.
Hi, Jack.
Jack.
Jack, you look sharp.
Yeah, I know. You just came from old Bert Sting's funeral.
So how was it?
It's all right. It was an okay little funeral. Quiet.
Funerals are like that.
Boy, that Bert was something. I must have arrested him a dozen times for disturbing the peace. Sure liked to enjoy himself.
Get it while it's going.
Hard living killed him.
He was 97 years old.
That's old.
Not to me.
Yeah, it's a generous kick at the ball.
Well, the wake is tonight. I was wondering if you fellas would come along with me.
No, we haven't been invited. Maybe the family would consider it an intrusion.
What family? There's just me, Bert's lawyer, and his barber.
His barber? That's unusual.
Are you serving dinner?
No, they're not serving dinner.
But why not? How, what the heck? Huh? Might be a hoot. Let's go.
You can count me out. I didn't even like him when he was alive.
What are you guys doing up this early? I thought you played all night and slept till noon.
Cheap gossip.
Jack O'Gorman told me.
He should talk.
Morning.
Pretty, isn't she? Huh?
Beautiful.
Yeah. That's Tim Hanks. Thinking of buying the Alibi Wahoo.
Well, they're asking a lot of money.
He's a dentist.
Well, what would he want with a boat like that?
Recreation for the family.
Hmm? See ya.
You believe that? Some dentist wants to buy my boat for family holidays.
Yeah, it's a bizarre world.
I'm going to get the money.
How?
There must be a way. Hey, would your father be...
No way. My dad walks a fine line between being careful and cheap.
At the bank.
That's a little over the line, isn't it?
I'm not going to rob it. I'm going to get a new business loan.
Do you think the fact of being underage and unemployed will work against you?
I think being young and ambitious will work in my favor. And besides,
The bank manager's a good friend of Gramps.
Ladies, that's your bus. You better get going. You're welcome. Really, give it to this really is my
Was it enough to work today?
Oh, it's good for you. I was working when I was 8 years old. Not just as though I could go to some fancy art school, so that I could eat.
Wow. You know, I don't think those tourists have ever seen a Mountie before.
Oh, they from Europe?
No, Toronto. Some pie, please?
Sure. I'll be right with you.
The bank manager's a diphead.
It's their stock and trade.
Sit yourself down there, my friend. Sarah. John?
Evening, Nick.
How are you, you old goat? Hey.
Oh, all right.
What's the matter with you?
He's had a bit of a shock, so don't fuss him. We've just come back from reading Bert Sting's will, and the sole beneficiaries are the SPCA and your grandfather, eh? You all right, Jack?
Why would he give me all his property?
Property?
Bert's warehouse? And the parking lot?
That's right.
Holy macaroni. It's prime downtown land. That must be worth at least 75 grand.
Yeah. Bingo!
Go ahead.
I'm a little spooked.
Why?
Well, this is Bert's place.
He doesn't need it anymore. That's why I gave it to you. Open the door.
I didn't know that.
Five plays for a nickel is a great deal.
I remember when a nickel bought two movies with change left over for popcorn.
What are you standing there for? Come in.
Bert died in this place. Probably in that rocking chair.
Yeah, it looks like the most comfortable chair in the place.
Some of these things must be worth quite a bit.
It's priceless.
It looks more like a hideaway than it does like a place of business.
Perfect.
I didn't have a friend and no place to go.
I'm not worried about it. Gramps will sell the property all by the boat. Hey, Wimpus.
Does your grandfather know?
No problem. He doesn't care about the property. I'm just worried about finding a buyer fast. Hey, Nick? Nick!
He's not in.
Well, we were supposed to meet him here. We're going to take the Alibi Wahoo out for a test drive.
He didn't say anything to me about that.
Well, I must have forgot.
We won't be long. You do have the keys, don't you?
You guys will have to wait for Nick.
Jesse, why are you making such a big deal out of this?
That boat is worth 58...
Six.
Grand. You're really not interested in buying it.
Oh, no. But Gramps is.
She runs smooth as silk.
He was an artist.
Took him 7 years to restore.
I can believe it. He was really careful.
He was building a dream. Mine. I finally got something I want.
Well, it's not in the bag yet.
That will be.
I don't know. Could be the Ginger Broxton story all over again.
Hi, boys. Oh. I want to talk to you, Will Garman.
What about?
The inheritance.
What about it?
Now, what are the plans for it?
Well, I don't know. It's not mine.
You reckon he might be interested in selling?
You interested in buying?
Maybe.
Why would you want a warehouse?
I'm considering spreading my financial assets, part of my expanding business policy.
What sort of business?
I reckon this town could use a new pool hall.
Great idea. So, how much are you offering?
What's it to you? Like you said, not your property.
Wait a minute.
Yo!
Hey, John. Now, will you look at this? Details are incredible, beautifully made.
But not by Bert. The only bottles that interested him had whiskey in them.
This is great. I used to play one of these in high school. I love the sax.
You want to hear Artie Shaw or Benny Goodman?
Doesn't matter.
Jack, do you realize what you got here?
Bert's life, all crated and boxed.
You could turn this place into a tidy business.
Yeah, a curio shop.
I don't know.
Look, I'll offer you $50 for the sacks.
I don't think so, fellas. I think Bert would like to keep this place just the way it is.
Bert doesn't care. It's up to you.
Is this a private club or can anyone join?
Hey, Jesse, come on in.
Wow. This place is great.
I'll offer you $75 for the sacks.
Tim Hinks came by. He wants to take the Wahoo out for a run. I said it was okay after the boys got back.
Fine. Wait till you see this jukebox. What boys?
Pat and Graham. They said you okayed it.
John!
Jack, I'll see you later. And Jack, I like this place exactly the way it is.
You know what? I think I'm getting my chops back.
Go home and practice.
You mean I could take it home?
Take it.
Thanks. Ciao. Great news. I sold the warehouse.
So, what did he say?
He said to come back after he'd eaten and we'd talk about it then. I think Gramps just wants to feel it's his decision. It is.
Oh, no problem.
I mean, he's the one who's always telling me that I should stay in Gibson's.
What else did he say?
He said Nick was PO'd at me. He got that right. Nick wouldn't even look at my offer. Threw me out of his office.
Oh.
And up.
You're just in time, boys. Help yourselves.
Oh. No. Thanks.
Thank you.
Arnold, we have company.
Mrs. Crispin, I've come to bring you a firm offer on your son's boat.
Arnold, this is...
Pat O'Gorman.
Graham Blake. How do you do, sir?
I do great, because I work on it. Here. Hit me as hard as you'd like.
No, thanks. I'd rather not.
Don't make him hit you, dear. He's had a long boat ride.
I brought you a firm.
How old do you think I am?
I have no idea.
Guess. Go ahead.
I don't know. 60?
Ha! 62! And I can't pinch an inch anywhere.
Would you mind just having a quick peek at this offer?
For what?
For the boat. Oh, I want to buy the Alibi Wahoo.
Well, a friend is handling the sale.
Nick! Yes, I know him, too.
You'll have to speak to him. Well, you picked a good day to visit. I baked this morning.
That's my boat.
Looks like Hank took her out for a spin.
Oh, he's gonna love her. Well, time does fly. Thank you very much. It was very nice. The baking was excellent. See you. Bye. Yeah, we'll see ya. Oh, would you look at that guy? We gotta get the deed to Relic. We gotta get the cash from Nick. It's time to put the screws to Gramps.
This song takes me back.
I bet.
London, 1943. Mavis Sheffield. I had a pretty good war. The kid wants me to sell the inheritance.
Yeah, he told me. What do you want?
I like it the way it is. Gives me someplace to go.
Then keep it. Enjoy it.
Well, maybe I owe the kid. I never had very much, so I couldn't give him anything.
You loved him, you looked out for him. That's the ballgame.
Oh, well. He'll inherit it all when I join Bert. Not that I'm in any rush.
Then keep them both waiting.
Hi, Gramps.
I haven't finished my dinner.
It's important, Gramps. My whole future depends on it. I'm sorry to pressure you, but there isn't much time.
Relax. I've made up my mind. No.
No?
No, I'm not selling.
But you said...
It seems to me that you did all the talking.
Gramps, this is a way for me to earn a living. I want you to be able to sit and relax... And enjoy your golden years.
That's just what I'm doing.
You can't do this to me, because I'll lose the boat.
There are lots of boats around, kid.
Not like this one. I want her for both of us.
And I want this warehouse for me.
That's not fair.
What's fair?
For as long as I can remember, I've been looking after you. I've never asked you for anything. This one time... I come to you for help, and you won't. You're a lazy, selfish old man.
Take it easy, Pat.
You stay out of this, Nick. It was probably you that convinced him in the first place. Oh,
Nick, I'm glad I found you. I need you and the Persephone. There's been an accident. The Alibi Wahoo's just gone down.
Oh, no.
I'll be back.
not sure. They think he going too fast, ran into a deadhead.
Jerk. It's Tim Hinks.
I know.
You sank my boat.
How could you, you idiot?
Pat, back off. The guy's in shock.
He's in shock. What about me? I can't believe that guy.
It was an accident. These things happen.
I saw him take her out. He drove through the channel like a maniac. I mean, she was the best boat I've ever seen.
What difference does it make? You didn't have enough dough to buy her anyway.
True, but I think I could have changed Gramps' mind.
No chance. He likes the warehouse the way it is.
Selfish.
He likes it. Don't spoil it for him, Pat. Besides, the alibi wahoo's at the bottom of the channel. That makes her fair salvage for anybody that wants to bring her back up.
Why didn't I think of that?
Well, think about it.
Yeah. That was nice of you, Nick. Are we going to help him?
We might. Depends on how he asks. John, how's he doing?
Oh, he's going to be okay, just a little shock. His dental assistant is taking care of him.
Listen, I'm going over to Jack's for a little while. You want to come along?
Sure, why not? Laurel's got a couple of lady friends visiting.
John.
Sorry, I can't. Duty call.
Thanks for everything, huh?
Sure.